I'm looking at small unit water purifiers that were selected based on selection and screening criteria that was given to me by the Special Operations Command and Special Forces Command at Fort Bragg. And we selected five candidates, and we're focusing more on the chemical aspect, because before they were looking at the microbes, removal of microbes, and that's understandable because, you know, microbes cause acute illnesses. They hit you fast, and, you know, that's understandable why they wanted to focus on that. But now, since we've been in these countries like Afghanistan and Iraq for long periods of time, over 10 years, we're starting to see chemical effects of our soldiers when they're coming back.
His interest is in looking at the range of chemicals that are of importance as contaminants in water, and this is the first study that we're aware of that is really looking at that range of chemicals as applied to its removal by point of use treatment processes.
Since we've been deployed to these regions like Afghanistan and Iraq for over 10 years now, we're starting to see the long-term effects of chemicals in some of the soldiers. Cancer causing agents, they can be carcinogenic, high lead levels in blood, arsenic, cyanide, mercury, those are the things that are pretty dangerous in the long term.
I did some work on military water purifiers back in the 1980s, but that was for personal water purifiers, individual purifiers, and this was a new opportunity to look at the kinds of units that are now being deployed for special operations forces and have never been properly evaluated for their performance. And here's a fellow like Jay, who's very concerned about the soldiers that he serves with in the field, in these special operations forces units, and the safety of their water.
The other side of the challenge is the engineering challenges, and these are more up our alley. These are coming up with systems that allow us to automate the operation of the equipment.
What I'm trying to do with my PhD research is to evaluate and assess different technologies, water purifier technologies, see how well they remove the microbes, see how well they remove chemical contaminants, and then offer that to the Special Operation Forces and give them a list of potential candidates that they can use out there. This research that I was conducting was specifically for Special Operation Forces, but it could benefit organizations like World Health Organization, the CDC, Center for Disease and Control and Prevention, the US EPA, as well as disaster relief agencies.
All the attributes of the kind of student that can be very successful in carrying out this research. So he's the right guy for the job at hand, and I'm very confident that he will have a successful PhD project as the product from this research.